Disco trance, they were clear on last week.
Oh, ah. The pants dance, what a sweet song. Actually, you've always had a good voice, haven't you, Dom?
I see you, I feel you. That is how I know you so well.
And if I recall, lovely ladies would swoon at your feet.
Not unusual, wild to go out at any time. It's not unusual, wild to at any time. But if I kind of don't you dirty grannies, get the water. It's not unusual to love you any time.
Oh, hey, leave him alone.
No matter what you do.
Leave him alone.
Go on,
you
do? I feel like I can.
Get up.
Yeah, that's exactly how I remember it. Can we move on, please?
I'm Dick, he's Dom, and welcome to the Dick and Dom Diaries.
These are the diaries of Dick and Dom. They had us on the low and you've come along to play the maddest games you've ever seen and meet oddballs in between. Diaries of Dick and Dom. Diaries of Dick and Dom. Right, idiot, and the neighbour's cat. Melvin O'Toole and dear Harry Bat. Dreaming up on dirty Norris and mushy peas. And don't forget...
The following stuff and nonsense from Dick and Dom in the Bungalow was first shown live between 2002 and 2006. Enjoy!
Little Nolly Muckman's here with another thought-provoking session of game. Yep. Yep. Or no game. Two boxes, one choice. One box contains the name of a game which you see on the board over there. But you really don't want to know what's in the other. Yes. Yes. Box. So, it's time to ask that all-important question. Game? Yes, I know! Or no game? It's time to choose your box. Okay. Sure you want to go for this box? You don't want to go for this one. You do want to go for this one. Do you want to unchange your mind and go for this one? Maybe you want to change your mind back again and go for this one. You're wavering, I can feel it. I don't know which way you're going to go, but you're going to go for this one. It's the final call. Let's take a look. Good luck. It's Yum Yum Yak. Oh, skillfully played. It's a great bungalow classic. Just have a look at this.
When it comes to choosing chocolates, can you spot a winner? Will you pick a saint?
Yum, yum.
Or will you pick a sinner?
Thanks, Shirley. Yum Yum Yak, over here, we've got a load of Chocky Wocky Doodah. Now, there's 12 of them. 11 of them are Yum Yum. One of them is Yas. All right, then, so shall we do it?
Yep.
Got more wall paint for you, son. That's it. That's tense. It's like a teepee and a wigwam. 2 cents. Let's go, you first. Number 9. Is that Yum Yum or is it Yak?
Yum Yum.
It's Yum Yum. Let me spin. I'm going for Chocky Walky Doodah Numero Cuatro. Es Espanol. Four. Yum yum.
Well, it looks like this game might go on for a while, so let's come back to it later.
This is the part of the show, with all the bits outside the bungalow. We tease the public with a joke or a trick. Blackity, meaty, dirty days and spotted dick. We met the nation as we travelled up and down, so grab your coat for Bungalow Bound Town, Bound Town.
Dominic Wood here, still on the quest to find Britain's maddest town. Today I'll come to Cardiff to find out how many people are mad enough to put on a pink wig, put on a moustache and shout out, Spam Fritters! Spam Fritters! Let's find out. Can I ask you a quick question? Are you mad?
Am I mad?
Yes.
How are you talking about?
No? Do you put one of these on your head?
No,
one of these on your lips?
No.
Do high kicks and shout out Spam Fritters?
What is all this today, Dom?
It's absolute gobbledygook.
Telling me.
What?
But most of all, I love you, cause you're you.
Oh, very good, very bravo. Will you put this on your head, this on your top lip, and do some high kicks while shouting out Spam Fritters? You'll do it. Go on, get. Spam fritters. Yes, more. Spam fritters.
More like this.
Yes,
spam fritters.
Spam fritters.
Spam fritters.
Thank you very much.
Spam fritters.
Thank you very much. Look, it's me today. Are you both mad?
Mad?
Yes.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yes. Well, you won't have any problem with putting this on your head.
Oh, no,
this on your top lip. High kicking and shouting out. Are you mad?
Yeah.
Very mad.
All right, stick that on your head, quick. Go on, stick that on your top lip. Go on, then.
Right.
There you go, lovely. And do some high kicks, right, while shouting out Spam Fritters. Go on, scream it out.
Spam Fritters.
Scream
spam
it.
Spam Fritters.
Spam Fritters. Spam, no, don't trip over that. Go on, more.
Spam Fritters.
More,
spam
more.
Fritters.
More,
spam
more.
Fritters.
Right, that's it. I'm out of it. Are you mad?
No.
Will you put this on your head?
No.
This on your top lip?
No.
Do high kicks?
No.
And shout out Spam Fritters?
No.
Is that a...
That's
yes?
A no.
Oh, that's a no. Okay.
Spam Fritters!
What? Keep going, more!
Spam Fritters! Spam Fritters!
He's nuts, isn't he?
Spam Fritters!
No, she's lost it! She's gone mad! She's gone loopy!
Spam Fritters!
Yes!
Spam Fritters!
Yes!
Hey!
Let him go!
Whoa. Oi!
Hey! Thank you very much. Absolutely, 100%.
Thank you.
Matt. Now put this on your top lip. There you go, on, ready? What's wrong? I have to put it on your nose, your top lip's too small. Put it on your nose. There you go. And now what I want you to do is kick your legs and shout out Spam Fritters.
Spam Fritters!
Spam Fritters!
Spam Fritters!
Spam Fritters! And stop. Thank you very much.
I am mad, been mad all my life.
Go on, will you put this on your head, this on your top lip, and do some high kicks while shouting out Spam Fritters?
Oh, I can't do that.
Go on, go on, go again. Go on, Spam Fritters!
Yes!
Go on, go on, go on, yes! And cut, thank you very much, before you scare all the children. Well, there you have it, 6 out of 10, just above average. I expected better from you, Cardiff. Now eat it. Three. Eat it. Is it yum yum or yak?
Yum yum.
Oh no! Alf. We're going for number 12. Yum, yum.
Roll up, roll up, it's time to meet the strangely talented, very unique. Roll up, it's time to meet the strangely talented, very unique.
The humans.
Now Matt seems to have got some. Matt seems to have got some zit puss on his face.
Go on then.
Right, let's see what the Bungalow heads have said about it.
1 out of 10, very stupid. 2 out of 10, it was disgusting. Nothing, because it did not get me. It's Jean, the athletic grandma.
It's very different.
Very different?
That's quite good, though, isn't it?
Quite good?
Thank you.
Yeah, they thought you're wicked.
Really?
Yeah, you're wicked.
Oh, you haven't seen me when I start.
Jackie Chin!
Don't try this at home, you'd be stupid too. Really stupid. Because it's a big table.
And it's very heavy.
No.
No!
No! Oh, yeah!
No, no, no!
Clap! Oh. Very good, okay. And quickly, the last thing.
The bike. No,
very quick.
Not. He's got the bike. He's gonna try the bike.
Live bike. It's gonna balance a bike.
He's balancing a bike on his chin! Look at it!
A real bike!
No!
On his chin!
Just! No way!
Clap! 10 out of 10, because he's got a good talent and he's cool.
Cool.
10 out of 10, I really like it. Wicked. Beth, I like it. I think she likes it. Cool, what was that? Pretty good, very talented, wicked. I'm happy with it. There you go. You've got a total of 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70.
Dick and Dom, I like you. You're new, you're fresh, and I love the bit where you go...
He's a cat in a flap, it's a matter of fact that he likes a good chat all about this and that. He's a bungalow star and he's your travel bar, so there's no turning back from the cat flap.
Chat attack!
Stop right there. Which cat will never get the cream? Which Moggy's feeling groggy? I think you'll be after the weakest link.
Annie, you are naughty. Hello, Cat here. Yes, it's true. I mix with the stars these days. But in my eyes, none shine brighter than today's guest from the bungalow, the one, the only half-dog, half-chicken, Barky Cluckinson. Oh, low five, Barky, low five. Barky, welcome to my cat flap. Oh, well, the pleasure's all mine, Barky. Let's start at the beginning. Basically, you were the figment of a bungalow head's imagination.
Right, cluck like a chicken then, Brogan. Go on. And apparently you bark like a dog as well. Go on, then.
So well, now, if you could put them both together, that'd be really nice. Okay,
and be like a dog chicken.
I can't.
You can't?
Oh, right, maybe you need some inspiration.
Yeah, I'll tell you what, you sound a bit like the dog that lives up the road. Barky Cluckinson!
He's half chicken, half dog. He's got the head of a dog, the body of a chicken, and the feet of a dog.
And he makes...
Hey there, mate, you're right. Safe.
He makes the sounds you do, Brogan.
How's it going, man?
It's a dog, and it's a chicken.
Yeah.
Walk off, black, black. Oh, hold on.
Hang on.
Hold on. Hold on. Oh.
He's made of mini Barky Cluckinson.
No, it's an egg. He's produced a mini Barky Cluckinson.
Well, a star was indeed born. And it didn't take long before your talent as a jazz musician came to the fore. Although musically talented, you then went on to host Top of the Pops.
Oh.
Calm down, Barky. Yes, that clip did indeed feature your longtime rival, Meowie Crocola, a rivalry which became quite public.
Come on, Barky!
Barky! Barky! Barky! Barky!
Come on, Crocola!
Barky!
Will you put all that behind you with your very own chat show?
It's Saturday. It's time to welcome the King of the Kings of Chat. It's Barky Cluckinson.
Always tricky on a live chat show when your guest is a little hoarse. A little hoarse. What? You actually talk the hind legs off of him. Stop it, Barky. There's still so much to talk about, and I could listen to you all day, but sadly, we've run out of time. No, thank you. Barky Cluckinson, everyone. Oh, wonderful. What a wonderful all-round entertainer.
Ow! Will someone get that ginger moggy out of here?
Oh, that's rich coming from you, love.
That's getting very tense. Well, look, one of these is yak. If you just tuned in, we're not just eating chocolates. What number was that?
One.
Hey, yum yum or yak?
Yum yum.
Oh, no! I can't stand it! It's a bungalow chocolate.
Nobody watch this bit, because I've got a cold and I'm feeling a bit poorly.
It's the pick of the show and a long-running blow to the hoity-toity folk who don't enjoy a joke. If you've got a heart condition or a nervous disposition, go and buy some airports and call a good physician, because we're going to shout
monkeys
till we're banned from every building in the world.
It's Premier League Bogies, where we play the game in places other people dare not.
We're at the Barnfield Theatre in Exeter, where we are going to attempt to play Bogies during a performance of Peter Pan the musical.
Yes, that's right. We're going to play Bogies during the show.
Welcome to the Barnfield Theatre.
All children grow up.
That's right. Apart from Dick and Dom, of course, who are here to play Premier League Bogies.
Have you ever seen a map of a child's mind?
Bogies.
McCall Jones begins with 2.4. In front of this capacity crowd of 289 people
going round all the time.
Here to see this production of Peter Pan. This, one of the tensest matches.
Bogies.
As you would expect here in this Premier League, that's 4.0 from Wood. So far, the performance has been tremendous from these boys.
Bogies!
McCourt braves a 4.7. Attracting some attention from the crowd.
Bogies!
Wood lifts the game, 5.2.
All children grow up, except one.
once again, we'd like to point out that this should not be attempted by amateurs. Dick and Dom have trained for many years to play at this terrifying level. Has he got... Yes, he has. He's got a 7.4.
Bogies!
Wood, losing all fear, 7.9. Ooh, not good. No! No. Will there be a response? He knows it's all or nothing.
Yes!
It's a 9.1. A showstopper. And quite rightly, they get out. Ooh.
Bogey!
What a super bogey! Please, do not attempt this yourself.
Two left. If you get another yum-yum, then you've won.
Yum-yum.
They absolutely stink. So, have you got another big finale up your sleeve?
Oh, no finale.
Just a cucumber. I'll introduce you into the show then. Mm-hmm. Today's Muck Muck finale is a tribute to one of the all-time, all-round entertainers, Mr. Brucey Forsyth.
Oh.
Yes. And believe it or not, today he is 107 years old.
I choose to believe not.
Correct. And it's also possibly untrue that he invented light entertainment.
What? He invented the words light entertainment.
No. Light entertainment itself. Can you imagine a world without light entertainment?
I'm starting to.
So, here, in our humble opinion, is how a prime-time weekend entertainment spectacle can be ever so slightly improved.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's Strictly Come Mug Mug.
Welcome again. Strictly Come Mug Mug. Live on a Saturday morning, isn't that lovely? Nice to muck you, to muck you.
Nice!
Yes, isn't that fabulous? Well, let's get straight on with the competition and meet today's judges. Now, hello, my darlings, all right, are we? Yeah, right. Now, our first judge is the world champion ballroom dancer, Javier Cedrics. Javier, how are you?
I'm fine, thank you very much.
But are you looking forward to the competition?
I'm quite excited, to be quite fair.
Well, yeah, of course you are. Now, next to you, of course, one of the top dance agents in the business and a close personal friend of mine, viewers, is the marvellous Len Poodle.
Oh, thank you, Brucey, thank you.
Well, not at all, Len, lovely to see you.
It's always a pleasure, never a chore.
Absolutely, I couldn't put it better myself. Now, and of course, on our panel this morning, a very old friend of mine, a female ballroom champion from 1901, all those years ago, it's lovely Treacle.
Thank you very much.
That's right, nice to see you, darling. You're looking absolutely divine. Now, let's get on with the dancers this morning. I think we should move straight on with our first couple, please.
Dancing the waltz, will Lucy and Andrew please take to the muck floor?
Now, viewers, a little bit of explanation. Lucy's had to go off because she's a little bit poorly, so Andy's going to die. I'll tell you what, why don't you have a little dance, Javier? Show us what you're made of. You're a professional. Have a slop about whenever you're ready. Let's have a round of applause, and here they go. Oh, he's terrible. Oh, dear. Oh. 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 Well. Yeah. Wasn't that much? Come over here, come over here. Don't be shy. Behave it. Oh, you're going to have to comment on yourself, dear. Right, so, Andy, I thought you did very well. I thought you moved like a little Jack Russell in a shed full of cream. Now, Havia, if you could give comments on your own performance and Andy's.
Well, I thought I was absolutely fabulous, to be quite frank with you.
Very well done. Now, what about you, Len? How did you find that?
Well, Brucey, you see, the waltz is a dance that requires a lot of spinny, and the key to it is getting a smooth slide on your Norris, which Javier had lovely.
Yeah, we did, yeah.
And Andrew did very well with. I think a few more years we could see potential champions.
Yeah, well, do you mean potential champions? Marvellous, isn't it? OK, and what about you, Treacle?
I thought they was marvellous, aren't they? 10.
Well, you go ahead, dear. 10. Let's have your scores now, then, the rest of you. We've got Avia. What have you got there? 8?
8.
9. What's that? 17 and 10 is 27. Righto, here we go, Lucy and Andy. 20 and 7 on the complex board there. Martin, thank you. Go back to your seat, Andy. Very well done to you. Right, let's move on straight away with our next cup. Nice, lovely. Well, come over here, girls. You did marvellously marvellous. Do you know, I thought that was enchanting. It's not up to me, of course, it's up to our judges. Havia, turn around, dear. There we are, face camera. Havia, what have you got?
Absolutely amazing. They truly have the essence of dancing.
They have the essence. Very good. What about you?
Well, I thought they took to the floor like dog poo sticks to a carpet. Lovely.
Fair enough. And what about you, Tree?
Yeah, I thought they were all right.
All right. Well, let's have a look at your scores then, dears. There we go. 10 out of you, Havia. Oh, six. No,
six.
16 and 9 is, I don't know, something or other. Finally, a little treat for you judges. It's Dick and Dom doing the tango. Please, lads, here we go. Quick comments, please, off of you, Havia. Marvellous form, Len.
I thought they gave it to us in bucketfuls there.
Bucketfuls, where are you, Treak?
A good performance.
Let's look at your scores, then, dears. 7 and 1 is 8. And what have you got, Treak? 18. There we go. Well done, boys. The winner is Lucy and Andy are the winners. Everybody get on the floor for a final dance. Here we are. Isn't it marvellous?